Hi guys, welcome down to the brand new left-handed series. And this time, it's not going to be me.
It's going to be this man. This is Ant Wilson, 12 handicapper, member of Stockport Golf Club up here in the northwest of England. And myself and Ant are basically going to get him back down to single figures.
That's the job, Andy.
That's the goal.
The big job on your hands.
What was the old handicap? What was the lowest you've been to?
7.2 was the lowest I got down to.
7.2. What's the goal?
Category one, ideally.
Cat one. Right, so minimum, by the end of this season, 7.1.
I think we can do that.
Cat one will be...
That'd be perfect. That'd be my nirvana.
Right, let's do it. That's going to do it. Guys, we're going to start off this series with a vlog. And today we are at the awesome Formby Hall Golf Club, where I actually have Euro Pro Tour, or had Euro Pro Tour qualifying. So we're going to have a bit of a practice round as well as a vlog. And we're going to vlog the back nine. So Anne's got six shots on me. I'm going to start with the first hole, 292 yard par four. So quite a stroke index 17 as well, so no shot. What we're going to do throughout this series is talk about what Ant's going to be working on in his swing, and also the strengths and weaknesses of his game, and obviously focusing mainly on the weaknesses. There's not that many, is there?
There's plenty of weaknesses, yeah. As you'll see.
Swing-wise, I'm going to talk you through what he's working on as we start to go around, and wedges and everything like that. And also a lot of course management is going to be absolutely key to lowering score and shot selection, etc, etc. So, Ant, do you want to get us away?
Absolutely, yeah. So 292 yard par four, looks like trouble down the left, water. I think I'm going to hit a hybrid towards the sort of traps on the right hand side. Nice, yeah. Easy play from the first hole.
Traps on the right hand side, we're looking at kind of 180 to reach the first one, 220 to clear all of them, so just keep it down the right side, really.
Play well.
Enjoy. Oh, loves the camera.
Believe me, there's nothing like that this morning. Although they only narrowly beat me.
And then the last hole. That was awesome.
Thanks. What are you thinking here then, Andy?
Just going to follow you, I think. Just forehand up the right side.
It's going to be a bit left of the traps, aren't we?
I'm actually just going to go pretty much at your ball. If it draws, great. If it doesn't, it's still in a great position.
Let's see it.
Sit there.
Yep.
Oh, cleared the water. Welcome to the gun show. That wasn't part of the plan.
109
into the pin.
109, right. Perfect position, really.
Slightly okay. Pleased that I didn't hit it about 10 yards off the tee. Yeah. Good start, fine.
The relief's done now, you can retire now. What's the play?
I'm thinking, you've got the traps on the right hand side there, for even you want to stay away from there. So my aim really is to be sort of 5 to 10 yards. Left of the flag.
Correct, yeah. Go for the fat part of the green.
Yeah.
There's no rewards for short.
Taking big scores out of the card, really. That's my goal as we move forward, isn't it?
That's where we're going to be there, right in the middle of the screen.
A nice little gap wedge, really. Try and play it nice. On
the dance floor, as you called it.
Yeah.
Two nice opening shots to your vlogging career.
So Andy, slightly fortunately in my opinion, has skirted the water.
It wasn't part of the plan. Like, I didn't think I had too much club, but clearly did.
To be fair, you've flushed it there with a 4-iron. What are you thinking?
65 yards, flag is tight to that right side, but We were quite aggressive at this.
So given your recent pitching series, I'm expecting this to be close, yeah?
It's been pretty good so far. Well, we've just played 9. Go.
Bit shy?
Yeah, I wanted to release, but not quite the strike. Birdie putt though, the chance.
Take that all day. What are you seeing, Andy?
Wow, massive right to left. I not only left it way too short, but I left it in the worst place.
Big slope that, isn't it?
Yeah, I've got to really go out up to the right. Let the slope swing it back.
It's coming. Yeah, you can have that.
Very generous of you.
Taking pity in your recent putting woes. This to the win. It's to go one up.
Lustrous start.
Oh, it'd be an amazing start.
It's coming down the hill. Go. Little bit shy, downhill scared him a bit.
Yeah.
I'd give you that, but everyone would go mad at me.
Yeah, you keep telling yourself that.
I'll remember, don't worry.
Good 5 foot left on that.
If you're a midget.
All right, straight up the hill, solid stroke. What's that toe? Yeah, well done.
Thank you.
Very nice conversion.
Take that for a four.
Yes, definitely. Two pars to start, all square to the second. Okay, so we're on the 11th hole. Here is a little map of the hole. We're going to go straight over, or to the right side, of these two bunkers, which are about 230 to clear from today's tee. Hans maintaining his honour.
Yeah, so I'm just going to try and play this, just right of those bunkers to the left there, and take the bad shot out of play, and then just leave it with a flick into the green.
Yeah, I think anything up to the bunkers, you've got about 130, 140 in, so no issues.
That's the plan.
Yeah, good. Go on, get over.
Between them?
Oh, just on top of that right bunker. Well worked.
Also played for it.
Well worked. I like it.
Thank you.
I'm going the same line, I think.
What have you got there, Andy?
Two iron.
The bullet.
It's got potential to do that. It's also got other potential.
You've hit it well this morning, so.
Fairway.
I rode it.
Well, sit. Yeah, it's alright.
Pleased with that?
Yeah, a bit blocky, but it's fine. It's not too bad.
Wow. That's going to be fun times. Just, you think you'd be playing off the back of your stance. Water left, flags there on the right hand side of the green. Yardage wise, you're not going to have that far. You're about 130 in. Have you zapped it?
120. I'm not zapping it because for me, I just need to take the water out of the play here. I'm thinking sort of maybe a 7-iron punch from the back.
Yeah.
Just keep it to the right hand side and hopefully it'll sort of flow over.
From the bunkers there, it will kind of feed back.
It's just going to be a bit interesting from this stance, really.
How much of a swing can you put on it?
Thinking sort of keep my club low on the back through as well, just kind of punch through.
A nice low squirty one to that, towards that right bunker or just left of it.
I'm not going to try and hit this hard, just need to try and control the ball really. If anything, I'm going to try and smother it so it goes right.
Yeah, there's no prizes for a lot short, but get it long. It's going. Still going.
Take that all day long.
That's done. That's done well, that.
It's done all right.
Well played. Guys, I'm going to talk you through very quickly what we're doing with Anthony's swing. So we've been working for a little bit the last couple of months, and from the top of the backswing, he generally gets a little bit too flat. So the right arm gets very, very low across the chest, and the club kind of almost goes across his shoulders at the top. What we've been trying to do is get a bit more separation between the right arm and the shoulders, like you can see there. That's obviously the practice drill version of it. So left kind of encouraging slightly less rotation, a little bit more disconnection between the right arm and the shoulders. Certainly going to help compression with his irons, and it's kind of done so already when we've played the earlier nine holes. Obviously woods at the moment might come out the occasional one a bit high or a bit fadey, but generally swing's adapting quite nicely.
So Andy, interesting position.
Yeah, you can tell I've not played it before.
My club selections are not right.
Yeah, you've gone big on a few fairways this morning as well, haven't you?
I've got 108. I've got a swing and I've got a lie. I've got not a bad lie.
You're thinking straight over the trees?
Yeah, just straight over the trees onto the flag as close as I can, really.
What
three
club?
Three quarter, 54 degree.
54.
Yeah.
What was your lie like, Andy?
Lie's good. Yeah, I've got no...
Excuses.
No excuses. Damn it! A bit above my feet.
Sounded like a good contact.
Go.
Can't quite get that at the end because it's gone through the trees. You see how you finished, Andy?
Pin high. Oh, nice, yeah, it's okay. About pin high, 12 to 20 feet, right?
Oh, great, thanks.
12 to 20 feet.
Well done.
Right, guys, so up by the green, here is my approach. And is just short of the green. He's got a shot on this hole, stroke index 9. What club are you playing? 54 degree wedge. He was going in relatively aerial. Okay, so just in case you can't hear that because of the wind, I'm going to pitch it just short of the surface here and it'll release up the hill. Has got a shot, so he's kind of got to make sure that he makes bogey at worst, up and down, has a good, really good chance of winning the hole. It's a nice strike. Come on, release. Oh, lovely shot. Yeah, well played. Nice. Planes landing here are just incredible, just flying straight over the top of us.
How do you see this moving, Andy?
Definitely downhill. Tiny bit from right to left at the start.
Are you going to go with a myth that everything breaks towards the water?
Well, this definitely does. Right.
Big putt, this.
This might need to go in for the half. Oh, stop.
I think I'll see that one coming back as well, to be fair.
Thought I had that. Damn.
Shoulda, woulda, coulda.
This for the win. Second hole in a row, put to win the hole.
Looks like a ball to the left to me.
I think you're right, yep. So, right to left as we look at it, guys. Left to right from his view. Start it on the line. The greens are very nice this time of year. Just on a bit of fertilizer on them.
And again, we noticed this morning, didn't we, that I was putting my toe up slightly.
So the toe was up. We've got the first green this morning. We just noticed that he gets his hands a little bit low and the putter toe is up. So he still needs to lift it a little bit higher.
Oh, enough to resolve that for me.
There we go.
That's one up.
See, guys, you know what? It's a win-win for me. If I lose, I win. Right, and goes one up.
No play.
Thank you. That's it. Nice height with the right arm, bit of separation.
Tough hole, this.
It's a very tough hole. 460 par 4. And has a shot. We're going to hit towards that kind of life buoy and bunker in the distance, which is about 290 away.
Too far for me.
At the moment. Yeah, good strike.
Thank you. I'll take that.
Good shot. Nicely played.
Cheers.
Popped up a bit, didn't it? But it's been better sort of strike than we've been seeing this morning. So what are you thinking in terms of shape here?
I'm going to go that left bunker.
Yep. Try and draw it off that.
With a little draw, yeah. So I want to just finish it to the left side of the orange.
So just to show you the one that Andy's sort of going for. It's just there. Drawing it off that towards the life buoy. He's absolutely drilled it.
That's the one.
See that landing just there, just left of that buoy. Yeah. Perfect, great
Holden
shot.
As well. Can't believe it.
Okay, so we're up to Ant's first ball. He's got 227 to the flag, which is there. Tree is in the way though. Normal shot shape would be a bit of a draw. We are getting you a little bit steeper, so I said you'll be hitting the odd fade with a longer club.
227, I'm just thinking sort of hybrid to just short of that trap on the right.
Good,
you know, man. I could hit a 3-wood and probably get out there, but I'm bringing that tree into play.
There's no point with it. The 3-wood's got to be one of the hardest shots to hit for any golfer. There's really no, obviously the reward's to hit the green, but the chances are slim for most golfers from that distance.
I'm going to try and cut this.
So slightly kind of aim at the right bunker,
yeah,
and just slightly open the feet a touch. To be honest with you, if it doesn't cut, you're still not in any danger. Oh, I just hit it through the tree. Where is it? Oh, there it is.
Just shot the green?
Yep, spot on that.
Take that.
So,
slightly fortunate.
He's got a shot. There's no point kind of trying to smash a 3-wood at it because the amount of spin that the 3-wood will create could slice it off to the left or double cross it to the right and then the hole's dead. Lay up with the hybrid, pop it on the green. Make the putt.
Sounds a good idea to me.
Easy.
What have you got left?
175.
Like a nice 7 for you?
Yeah, normally. Slightly.
Just touch off the right into,
slightly,
isn't it?
Into and off the right, but the flag's at the very back as well, so if I go over the back, I've got the worst possible chip.
It's all downhill, isn't it, from the back?
So I'm still going to hit the 7. I'm going to try and hit it really hard. If it gets back there, amazing. If it doesn't, I've still got an uphill putt.
Yeah.
The shot coming back is not the place to be.
Are you thinking shape or anything here? Or
just inside left of that right bunker.
Okay, just a little draw off that, yeah?
Tiny draw. Ah, too much.
Double cross?
Stay there. I think I'm actually on the green. We've got miles to go.
Not sure if I picked that up there.
Just left of the left bunker. I think it's on the green though.
Let's go and see.
Try to hit too hard. The problem you see sometimes.
Smooth.
No such word.
Okay, so, and just short. 54 degree?
Yeah, 54, yeah. Sort of try and pop it up halfway. Hopefully let it release out.
Right, so
slightly right to left as I look at it as well.
Similar kind of shot to what you had on the last, landing it around about here halfway and just let it release up. I'm stood at my ball, just on the fringe. Probably the most wayward iron shot I've hit today, actually. That's the problem.
Yep.
Alternative shot from there, guys, would have been just a little chip and run with a pitching wedge. Ant, just put another ball down and you do chip and run with a pitching wedge. So use that ball where it's finished, try and land it just over there. Just over that ball with a pitching wedge. So just gonna bit of practice just to kind of say, well, there's so much green to work with. There's a lot of kind of pressure on a bigger swing to get the 54 degree to land here. So just encourage him to hit maybe even a 9-iron or a pitching wedge. Personally, I don't really like the 7-iron shot, but it does have, it's a good one as well. Good alternative as well. Pitching wedge lands about halfway up. Just maybe caught that touch thin. But even there, still in a better position. Right, so Ant's going to take his par putt. Yeah, speed of play, guys. Flag's going to stay in, just to help you see where we're going to be aiming. And there's no penalty for this. It's January 2018. Looks like it's going to be uphill, his right to left, coming in from that far side. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Yeah, good effort.
Thank you.
Yeah, the chip just did you there. So I said, even just a pitching wedge or a thing. You got a gap wedge as well?
Yeah.
Just try and land it a little bit further up, a little bit shorter. Less pressure on the swing.
Yeah, just tried to pick it a bit too easily. So, open the door again for Carter.
Not a massive amount in this. Left side, about a foot.
You just need.
This is the one I'm really concentrating on.
Just get it up there and put the pressure back on me, I guess.
Come on.
Great effort. Well done. You can have that.
Thank you.
Great putt. For him.
Yeah.
So I need this for the half.
You got this for the half. Yeah, come on, we want you to roll this in. Everyone is willing this putt in right now.
Except Carter.
No, I want this to go in.
Yeah. I'm gonna go, as you said this morning, just, you know, uphill, take a break out of it, be positive with it.
Correct. Not much really coming off that, I don't think. A brief look.
Should be pretty straight, he says.
Get the club face sat correctly. Still want a bit more. Oh.
Pull.
Hard luck. Chip, did you?
All square.
Right, all square through three. Guys, thanks very much for watching. This is part one over and done with. Massive thank you to Formby Hall Golf Resort and Spa for hosting us. Loads more to come with Ant as we get him back down to single figures and then on to category one.
Stop those chips.
And we need to sort that chipping out. Guys, join us in part two where the match continues and we'll see you again very, very soon.